In the last 5 years, Narendra Modi's BJP government have chosen a path of systematic discrimination, be it the abrogation of Article 35A in Kashmir or the citizenship law, calling the recent violent community clashes seeks to normalise a far more sinister event. India is now controlled by Hindutva supremacist RSS ideology.
वेलकम दोस्तों, इस वीडियो में बात करेंगे सिटीजन अमेंडमेंट एक्ट पर हुई यूके में डिबेट के बारे में। जी हां, ब्रिटिश के पार्लियामेंट में सिटीजन अमेंडमेंट एक्ट पर बहुत बड़ी डिबेट हुई थी, जिसके बारे में इंडियन मीडिया ने उतना कुछ खास बताया नहीं, लेकिन उस मीटिंग में काफी गर्मा गर्मी हुई। वो वीडियो लेके आए हैं जहाँ पर सिटीजन अमेंडमेंट एक्ट और दिल्ली के राइट्स पर बातचीत हुई। लेकिन आपके लिए वो CAA का हिस्सा लेके आया हूँ, जहाँ पर RSS को टारगेट करते हुए कहा गया कि इंडिया में RSS की सरकार है और वो अपना एजेंडा लोगों पे लादना चाहते हैं। सुनाते हैं आपको लाइव डिबेट, देखते हैं कि उन्होंने क्या कहा।
मिनिस्टर, वेल आई नो द ऑनरेबल जेंटलमैन टेक्स अ वेरी कीन इंटरेस्ट इन दीज अफेयर्स। आई वुड कमेंड एंड अप्लॉड एनी एक्शन दैट इज अटेम्प्टिंग टू टेक आउट द टेंशन, देयर इज सीवियर टेंशन करंटली इन पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया ओवर द CAA। सो आई वुड अप्लॉड एंड कमेंड एनी एक्शन दैट ट्राइज टू टेक आउट द हीट ऑफ द सिचुएशन।
एलन स्मिथ।
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. There's obviously a lot of agreement across the House, and I commend the Minister for his statement, which I would agree with as far as it went. And I think we in this House need to be clear that we can go a lot further on this. This situation has been, as we've heard, occasioned by deliberate Indian government policy in targeting Muslims with the citizenship amendments. But in short term, I think there is a real role for the UK government to do, which wasn't mentioned in the statement, which is to build on the resist framework of the government communication framework. In that I believe it's obvious that there is online disinformation being used within India in order to inflame these tensions. I'd commend the Government Communication Service and the Cabinet Office on this work. I think the UK is in a position to do a real assessment of the online actors and the malign actors who are, aside from the Indian government policy, which is one issue, and I would urge the Minister to step up his efforts in that dialogue. But there are online efforts that could be made against this sort of disinformation because people are at risk of further violence.
Minister.
Well, the Honourable Gentleman raises a very sensible and important point. I'm pleased that he welcomes that report. Any measures, be it attempting to clamp down on online disinformation or the measures that my Honourable friend for Harrow has raised, are very welcome. We are constantly in contact over these issues. We know how important this is to members of this House and their constituents who may have family involved in this area. So I appreciate his comments.
Minister Abgarmi.
Speaker, I welcome my right honourable friend to his new position. Can he confirm that he will use his high office, every power that he has, to make sure that our concerns in the House today are relayed to the Indian authorities, in particular the brutality which seems to have been meted out by those who should be enforcing the law, which was covered most recently by BBC coverage?
My honourable friend makes a very important point. I alluded to our concerns over some of the police brutality that was meted out. We have long regarded protest as a key part of any democratic society. Democratic governments must have the power to enforce law and order when a protest crosses the line into illegality. Yet we encourage, and indeed in this case, we encourage all states to ensure that their domestic laws are enforced in line with all international standards.
Yasmin Qureshi.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. In the last 5 years, Narendra Modi's BJP government have chosen a path of systematic discrimination, be it the abrogation of Article 35A in Kashmir or the citizenship law, calling the recent violent community clashes seeks to normalise a far more sinister event. India is now controlled by Hindutva supremacist RSS.